All right, hello everybody. We are live now, impromptu live, like I like to do often. And now I'd like to talk with you about the fundamentals and what I think there's seven fundamentals that I'd like to share with you and talk about. And I wanted to talk about this because I participated to a workshop recently, and this question arose. And unfortunately, I did not have time to actually really answer that question. So I wanted to answer it now with you guys, because if someone asked me that question, I'm pretty sure a few more people could benefit from the answer to that question. All right, so let's start. And let me know if you have any questions. You can always comment. All right, so, you know, there's this map, if you will, that maybe you've seen before, because I've used that visual in the past. And, you know, there's like seven big things for me that I think are important. And, you know, the first circle is, you know, the big picture, you know, so instrument technique and inside instrument technique that include sound, arpeggios, scales, and we can obviously go even deeper, and actually we're going to do that. Rhythm, you know, that includes swing feel, precision of your rhythm and your rhythmic creativity. And by the way, that's the whole purpose of my program, Rhythmic Considerations in Improvisation. And we actually talk about all those three things: swing feel, the precision, your accuracy of your rhythmic playing, and the creativity of your rhythmic playing. So that's all this is included in the program, Rhythmic Considerations in Improvisation, which is, by the way, both in English and in French. Ear training, same thing, you know, like intervals, and we're going to go actually a little deeper into that, chords and progressions, meaning that you have to be able to hear and recognize and then play on your instrument different intervals. And we're going to see which one are I consider fundamentals before going deeper. Same thing with chords and harmonic progressions. You want to be able to hear and understand basic harmonic progressions. Same thing in harmony, you know, the harmonic topic. There's some fundamentals that you need to understand and master before moving to tonal, modal, and advanced material. Repertoire, self-explanatory repertoire, really, I divide it in three big categories: blues, standards, and modern. And one could go deeper, you know, into ballads, straight eights, 3-4, 5-4, odd matters, you know, things like this. Improvisation technique, you know, for me, I always say vertical first. Vertical playing is important, is for me, is fundamental. I strongly suggest to be clear vertically. What that means? That means triads and seventh chord. Then you can or incorporate the blues scales, but that's, you know, but even blues scales, it's not that simple. I mean, it can be a trap. I hear a lot of people playing blues scales, but they don't really understand how to really to use the blues scales. Even the term blues scales is debatable. But first, arpeggios, triads, and seventh chord. Then horizontal playing, which means scales, because scales are arpeggios with passing tone. All right, C major scale, it's the C major score, C major chord, C E G B with passing tone C D E F G A B. All right, and so for me, the scales are chords with passing tones. D minor, the D Dorian, D minor 7, D F A C, that's my chord, and the passing tone are E G and B. D E F G A B C. So my targeted notes are the chord tones, and my passing tones are then building up the scale. And of course, then advanced improv techniques, which we're not going to go right now because, well, we're talking about the fundamentals. And history, you know, it's important for me. It's important to know some of the history that really put a lot of things together, and to understand, to listen to the masters. That's what I wrote, the masters and the milestones albums. You know, there's some albums that you can't not know. You know, and the origin. So even before the swing, the blues, you know, even before like the work songs and so on. So that's important also, because you're going to be able to make some connections with the current, you know, contemporary jazz musicians. All right. I think we went a little too fast. All right, so here we go. You know, for instance, in terms of scales, again, it's my experience that I have a lot of, there's some students come to me, I want to play bebop, or I want to learn the quatrain changes, I want to play giant steps, and so on. And, you know, if you can't master the major scale, melodic minor, harmonic minor scale in the 12 keys with triads, you know, I included the four note chords, but I could even just say the triads, some intervals, you know, then you cannot go into other stuffs. All right, so major, melodic minor, harmonic minor scales in all 12 keys, including the triads and the intervals. The intervals, and we're actually, I think, going to see that in the ear training, I could include it here. Basic fundamental intervals to practice are seconds, thirds, fourths, and fifths. All right, even so, really second and third, then fourth and fifth. You can go to the next level, which would be sixth, seventh, ninth, and so on. But first, you know, make sure, you know, it's a yes or no question. Are you comfortable playing third and, you know, up and down in F sharp major, in B harmonic minor, in A flat melodic minor, and so on. Articulation also, that's important. So I always say, okay, first legato, all right? No articulation, no tonguing for the woodwind instruments, legato, all right? Or every four eighth notes. Then articulation is important, because that's for woodwind instruments, that's, you know, the control of the attack. So you have basic foundational articulation, articulating every two eighth notes, or attacking two and phrasing two, or three and or two but on the upbeat, and so on. Tempo, you know, slow, medium, up. Then you can add chromatic passing tones in your scale. You can then go into bebop language, pentatonic scales, hexatonics, symmetric scales, which would be, you know, like where we would talk about Coltrane, which he used a lot of symmetric scales. And there are other scales that are even more exotics. All right, and always keep in mind, do not underestimate the importance of fundamentals, and do not overestimate your mastery. There's a little copy mistake here, your mastery of fundamentals. Again, some people say, oh yeah, you know, like my major scale, no problem. And then I put a metronome, I say, okay, give me the F sharp major scale, and I've lost half of the class. All right, so it's a yes or no question, you know. Are you past this first circle, all right, major in all 12 keys? Boom, yes or no. Here is another example, harmony, you know, triads. Again, triads in seventh chords, scales and modes. In the triads, then once you're very clear with the triads and the seventh chord, you can go into the extensions. You can go into upper structures. You can go into hybrid chords. But if you're not clear with triads, you know, triads root position, first and second inversions, triads closed and open. My friends, do not cumbersome your mind with extensions, with upper structures and stuff like this, because if it's slightly foggy over here, well, it's definitely going to be extremely foggy up there. All right, it's not like the sky. The higher you go, when it clears up, you can go above the clouds. But here, you gotta be above the clouds right there. All right, if you're in the clouds in the triads, then you're going to be even more in the clouds in the seventh, and you're just going to be very, very confused about extensions and stuff like this. And for us improvisers, it's not only to understand the triads and the inversions and closed and open, etc. It's being able to play those fundamental material with your instruments and without reading. All right? Scales and modes, the 2-5-1 cadence, major, minor. Be clear with the harmonic analysis. Some basic modulations and reharmonization. And, you know, one might argue that modulations and reharmonization should probably be in the second circle. All right. Ear training, you know, it's so intervals, unison. Because believe me, some people, you know, it's not that easy sometimes to hear a unison. Because if you hear a unison on the piano, yes, but a unison between a trumpet and a clarinet, well, you know, that's already a little challenging because you have two different timbres. So then second, thirds, fourth, fifths. All right, so these are the basic intervals you got to be able to hear. And their natures, major, minor, perfect, diminished, augmented. Because already you see that the second and the third can be major or minor. The fourth and the fifth can be perfect, augmented, or diminished. So that's already quite a few options. Once you're clear with that, hearing and recognizing those intervals, well, then you can go to the 6th, 7th, 9th, 11th, and 13th, and so on. Triads, 7th chords, then you go into the extensions. Be able to recognize the harmonic progression of the blues and some reharmonization, you know, like like the harmonization of Blues for Alice, and so on. And there's other harmonizations of the blues form. 2-5-1s here, you know, again, being able to hear and recognize 2-5-1s, contiguous 2-5s, hearing the substitutions, and so on. Melodies, you know, that means standards, being able to transcribe, to hear and play simple melodies. So, you know, melodies from standards. Standards melodies are, you know, pretty easy. Usually they're diatonic. They are around one scale. Most of the time, the standards, all right? The standards from the American songbook. I'm not talking about Coltrane, Bird, or After, you know? I'm talking about standards, songs. So the melodies are usually very diatonic, inside one key, one scale. The harmony is moving a lot. But, you know, again, you take, what is it, There Will Never Be Another You. It's all around, it's all around the E-flat major scale, if I remember correctly. The Stella by Starlight, the melody is all around B-flat major, and there is only one or two notes that are outside the key. So the melody of those standards are actually pretty fairly easy. So you should be able to hear and recognize and play. And of course, you can transcribe solos or some phrases, you know, but because then the melodies are much more complicated, much more advanced, you know, with more vocabulary and a lot more stuff to hear and understand. All right, so that's just like, you know, a few ideas about those fundamentals that I think are important. So let me know if you have any questions about this. I will be happy to answer. And so let me come back here. Here we go. All right, so the seven fundamentals. Do not overestimate your mastery of the fundamentals, and do not underestimate the value, the importance of the fundamentals. I always say, you know, I've been playing for 30 years, and I still practice the fundamentals. I still practice my scales, my arpeggios, and things like that, you know. You know, think about also people who play sport at a very high level. They always go practice the fundamentals. A tennis player, they always go practice each moves, the serve, the back, the forehand, backhand, and things like that, you know. And even though they've been in the top five of the, you know, world best tennis player. So it's fundamentals are fundamentals for that very reason, that they are fundamentals, the foundation of all of this. All right, my friends, so that's it for now. Let me know if you have any questions, and have a great day. I'll talk to you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.